Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our biology form 4, lesson 15, and your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on reception, response and coordination, under the subtopic, the comparison of tropic and tractic responses. Before that, we can have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to differentiate between tropic and tractic responses. Actually, I would like first to do something on nastisms, and we are going to do the introduction part of the nastisms before actually we go to the differences between the taxa and the trophics, because they are related to nastisms. These nastic responses, they are unidirectional, they are non-directional movements of parts of plants in response of diffuse stimuli. Such responses include folding of leaves in hot weather, opening and closing of flowers in response to intensity of light, and the closing of leaves such as those of Mimosa pudica when touched. These movements are brought about by tiger pressure changes at the leaf and petal bases of certain plants. At these bases, there are pressure-sensitive swellings called pulvini, which through loss or gain of turgidity bring about those movements. Nastic responses are also grouped according to the type of stimuli that evoke them. So now I would like us to look at the different types of nastisms, whereby the first type of nastisim we are going to look at will be nicti nasti. Or this nicti nasti, we can call it a slip movement. I would like we have a diagrammatic representation of the same. So I am going to explain the nicti nasti as you are observing the diagram, whereby we are seeing these are movements in response to differences in light intensity and temperature changes of the day and night as seen in sunflower. If the response is specifically for light, then it is called photonasty. Open in presence of light and close in its absence, and if it is specifically for temperature changes, then it is called thermonasty, as in flowers of some plants that open with increase in temperature and close with decrease in temperature. The second type of nastisim that we are going to look at will what we call aptonasty, whereby we are going to say this is the response to touch. The touch reaction in plants is most dramatic to the sensitive plant. For example, the Mimosa pudica, as is being represented by our diagram on our screen. The leaves of this plant will close rapidly if they or their stem are touched. A sudden change of temperature will initiate a response. Experiments with Mimosa suggest that a chemical agent is involved in these reactions. Aptonasty is also shown in a plant like the Venus flytrap, which is an insectivorous plant that grows in soil deficient in nitrogen, so it gets its nitrogen by trapping and digesting insects. When the sensitive hairs on the leaves are touched by landing insects, the midrib cells actually they lose water rapidly, causing the trap to spring, hence closing the leaf with the spines interlocking. We have other type of nastisim, which we can call a chemonasty. Well, let us have a diagrammatic presentation of the same. Chemonasty, we can say that this is the response to the presence of specific chemical substances of nitrogenous compounds, such as urea and ammonia compounds found in insectivorous plants. Therefore, when an insect is trapped by the tentacles of an insectivorous plant like the Venus dry trap, the insect provides the chemical stimulus for the release of digestive enzymes by the plants. We can have another type of nastisim, which we call hydronasty. We can have a diagrammatic presentation of hydronasty, whereby we can say this is a response to changes in humidity. Remember, hydro means water, and humidity is all related to water. This type of response is seen in some flowers, such as those of the dandelion genus, which close when the air is moist. I would like us to look at what we call the survival value of nastisims, or the importance of these nastisims. One of the importance is that they help in the protection of the inner delicate parts of flowers. Two, they help in reducing reduction of transpiration, for example, in the hydronasty. Three, we have got the regulate temperature, and we have four, It is a way of obtaining some limited mineral nutrients. For example, in those insectivorous plants. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are required to differentiate between ichthynastry and aptonastry. If you are keen, all through the lesson, you will be able. I'm very sure that you will not get challenges. To get more of this lesson, you can refer to KLB. Secondary Biology Students Book 4, which is the fall edition and has been certified by the Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you can subscribe to our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV underscore Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels, and we shall have many more of our biology lessons. Thank you.